A toxicologist performs laboratory studies and field surveys to measure the impact of toxins on humans, animals, plants, and the environment. They can conduct experiments to evaluate short and long-term toxic effects of potentially harmful substances or chemicals we come in contact with in our everyday lives. Environmental toxicologists study man-made and naturally occurring substances that are thought to be toxic. The overall objective is to determine if and to what degree any particular substance is toxic, and in some cases evaluate how mixtures of several chemicals can produce increased or decreased toxicity due to their interactions with each other. To determine just how toxic a substance is, the toxicologist uses what is known as a dose-response relationship. The effect on an organism exposed to varied levels of a toxicant over a specific time period will give the toxicologist data that will then be used to create a dose-response curve. The dose-response curve will indicate that point when an organism experiences adverse effects of exposure from a toxicant. Responses can include endpoints at varying levels of organization within an organism or within a population of animals, such as mortality. The log of concentration, or dose part of this curve, relates to the amount of potential toxicant that can be given to a test organism. In this case, it is mixed with water. The point where there is 50% mortality is known as the LC50, which is the lowest concentration divided by 50%. This represents the concentration of a chemical that has killed 50% after a specific amount of time. The curve begins at the point on the graph that is the lowest observable adverse effect or lowest concentration that produces a response from an organism. To explain toxicity further, I will use caffeine as an example. It is a substance that is found in nature and most of us are familiar with it. The average cup of coffee contains 80 milligrams of caffeine. After your body metabolizes the coffee, there will be about 1 milligram per pound found in the plasma. 80 milligrams is a dose in this example. The first feeling of alertness would be the lowest observable adverse effect and may be less than 80 milligrams depending on you as an individual. As you drink more coffee, you increase the amount of caffeine per liter in your plasma. There will be a point where you feel jittery. This will become another data point on the graph. The dose response curve is S-shaped and will be filled out with points that represent different doses of caffeine and the adverse effects it produces. Data collected from lab experiments using rodents, such as rats, indicate this concentration needed to kill these rodents with caffeine is about 200 milligrams for a 2-pound rat. If the first point on the dose response curve is the feeling of alertness after drinking coffee, and if the LC50 is where half of the test group dies from ingesting caffeine, then the highest point in the dose response curve is most likely fatal for the entire group drinking coffee. A toxicologist performs bioassays to find the LC50 as a way of comparing two toxic substances and their acute effects rather than the long-term possible effects or chronic reaction to a toxic substance being tested in a 96-hour bioassay. We would like to thank the EPA and LSU Ag Center for funding this video production.